I know she won't forget that we met. She hit her, broke her down, she a wreck. They saying more, you better than the rest. Who, me? I never would've guessed. Ricky, but I do it like a vet.
I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter.
Had to take the stairs to the top floor. Top. Every that slept been done for. Got a few bands, need a ton more. If we empty out the that's a drum roll. If we move five, hit him with the 100 strikes. Now that me like a real. Hold on, let me catch my breath. Hold on, let me catch my breath. We getting to the bread, it was crumbs. She love God, turn nothing into something. She let me knock it out the park, home run. I'm a giant bear bun. She told me that the money make a. She tried more than the mother. Ain't nothing. I've been always feeling like the one. These other, I'ma show how it's done.
I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter.
About 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. The excitement brewing here in South Florida as a moment ago the Dolphins starters were introduced to this home crowd. They're fired up as well as they get set to match up with the Carolina Panthers. Is upon us. It's week 12 of the NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. And a short kick taken at about the 16. The first carry for Bo Scarborough, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Second and six. Now they'll run it with Scarborough. And getting this just shy of midfield, he'll spot it at the 49.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea. Slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Here I come again.
Check.
Right there, 54.
Now Scarborough, and he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Behind the chain, second and 12. They'll try to throw now. Winston. He'll let this go for the end zone. That is caught by Waddle. Touchdown, Miami. Well, when it comes to throwing the deep ball, no one has ever questioned the arm strength of Jameis Winston. And this is a beautiful throw right here.
And we knew that this offense was going to try to put pressure on the secondary. That was something they talked about with us. They knew that they had an advantage, pressed it, and there you go. Big play for a touchdown on their very first possession.
And that throw, amazingly, well over 70 yards in the air, according to Next Gen Stats. Wow. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. After the PAT miss. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. First down, Allen. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Here's Devin Singletary. He played in this state at Florida Atlantic. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. This defense for the Dolphins, they really played well a week ago in that win over the Jets.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone in and run the ball? Or maybe just 1 or 2 receiver routes in order to try and keep your quarterback upright?
Flushed out right. And he'll slide to a halt here. Still a little shy of the first down marker.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
And I see an extra defensive back on the field. A little surprise here on third and one.
And what a weapon to have when you can use your quarterback as a short yardage runner and pick up first downs.
Now this time, Allen will throw. He'll get this out wide to Singletary. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Now Allen. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
They'll run on first down with Singletary. And only able to muster a couple, down to about the 27. 6-0 our score after one. Yards to go on second down. Allen gonna throw this to McLaurin out on the left side. That catch good for five. It's third down.
One thing we do know, he's gonna get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, gotta continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
The eighth play of the drive coming up. It's third and three. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. And he finds McLaurin. And they'll get this down to the 10.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there. And they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Allen. Taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's second down. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Allen, this one caught by his tight end, Andrews. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. If you're the offensive coordinator, you like looking at that section a heck of a lot better than trying to figure out third and long.
Third and two, they're going to elect to throw with Allen. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Byron Pringle, his first touchdown on the year. And the Panthers have tied this game up. They can take the lead with the extra point. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Prater for the extra point, and they take the lead here at 7-6. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. A short kick taken at the 18. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees.
And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. And he will finally go out of bounds, but not before he takes it down to the 25. So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Jameis to throw it. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. The first down screen pass, good for five.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll send you up to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there, and he'll have stats and scores from a busy Sunday in the NFL. Throwing again on second down. Winston. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
They run. This is Scarborough. Up to make the play defensively, Tre'Davious White.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. This is Scarborough. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Winston now. That's going to be caught by Waddle. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. This is a quarterback that's already in the top 100 all-time in passing yards, but that last throw going to move him past Roger Staubach on the all-time list. Roger Charles at 22,700.
Don't forget, he also won two Super Bowls, played from 1969 to 1979. And I would dare say Roger's numbers would be larger, but remember, he had a commitment to the Navy. A graduate of the Naval Academy, and back then, you had to serve your five-year hitch before you could go on and join the NFL.
He will push his way down to about the 14. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Looking right, looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Now a signal and a timeout call as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Winston. He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. DK Metcalf in the final seconds of the first half. And the Dolphins are going to jump back in front.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. Out there to go for two. Final play of the half here, Winston. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. It's the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. And the Dolphins are going to have the football at their own 1 yard line.
Well, as most teams do in their 2-point attempt, they pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you get a chance to take it all the way back at 2 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case here, but that's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside. Short kick. One of the up middle take it down. They're going to take this up close to the 40, so really good starting field position. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And you wonder if with Allen's arm, they might just take their chances by dialing up a long one. He hits Adams, complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. So the two teams will head to the locker rooms here in Miami with the Dolphins on top. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
On On second and very short, Allen looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Throwing on first down is Allen. And yet again, it's McLaurin.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Looking to throw again on second down. Allen, and his throw here is going to be incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over
them. Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Going to try and throw on third down. This one complete to Christian Kirk. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they convert on third and three with a nice gain of 7 yards.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
Again, they'll throw with Allen. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. Yeah, he was able to shed one tackle, but could not get away from there. That catch good for only a couple. Second down and 8. Now Allen, flush to his right. First down and more for Allen. And Allen will have the first down as he's able to slide to avoid the contact at the end.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Operating from the red zone now, Allen, and it's caught. Touchdown, Panthers! Devontae Adams, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Panthers are once again going to retake the lead.
I think if you polled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as a wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Snags it for the pick. Big seam, and he might go all the way. And he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as that play backfires in a big way. Still just a two-score game in the third quarter, but they're going to go onside kick here anyway. And the Dolphins are going to recover. I know they're down, but starting the third quarter there with the onside kick, what'd you think?
Well, I think that they're looking at it as we may not have as many possessions in this game as we want. There may be that sense and that feel that they've got to go ahead and make something happen, steal a possession, try and steal some points, and get themselves right back in a position to try and win the game.
Play fake. Winston. They'll roll him out right. Catch is made by Metcalf. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right. Trying to evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10.
Let's go, defense. Let's get out the field, defense. Kill, kill, kill.
Kill, Tony.
Hey, switch gears, switch gears.
Flip, flip, flip. Finish it.
Throwing, Winston. That's caught, Waddle on the left side. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. They'll run for it with Bo Scarborough. And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. Bo Scarborough with another touchdown, number 24 on the year. And the Dolphins are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. Well, for the extra point. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Three quarters in the books. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second down and 6. To the air, Allen. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. Got an open man. It's Pringle. A gain of 6 there on first.
Yeah,
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Second and four. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. Here's Allen to throw it. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Andrews. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now Allen, throwing the out route and complete. That's Andrews. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. To throw again on second down, Allen. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. So the completion good for just 3. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Here's Allen. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 21. Boy, how do you let a guy get that wide open in the two-minute drill?
There's absolutely no way that that's coached or taught. That's an absolute complete breakdown on that play.
Stride. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. He has been terrific today, hasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. Running flawless two-minute drill right here. This has been quarterbacking 101 with a flourish.
Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 ticks remaining on the clock. Options galore here, second and a few inches. He'll get this out wide to Singletary.
And the Panthers are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
The Panthers going to use the second of their timeout as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. First and goal, a touchdown and a two-point conversion here are musts. Throwing is Allen, sliding out of the pocket. And he gets in just in the nick of time, so they get the touchdown they need. Now they need a two-point conversion to tie it.
We'll break down the touchdown later. It's two-point conversion time. Go to your script, pick your play, and go for it.
Listen to this crowd now. Their guys need a stop on this two-point conversion. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. The late touchdown was only half the battle. Now they need the two-point conversion to tie the ball game. Now Allen, eluding the pressure right. And he will get in. The two-point conversion is good, and we may be on our way to overtime. Everything was riding on that two-point conversion, and they got it.
They got it. They now have the momentum. Time really dwindling in this game. Now their big deal is make sure they get a good kickoff and don't give up anything big on the defensive end.
A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now Winston. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. So on now for the field goal try, Chris Boswell. And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. So on now for the field goal try, Chris Boswell. This from Tom Dempsey range here.
This will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards.
So here's the veteran kicker, Matt Prater. His first attempt of the afternoon, and it's for the win. And it is good! He splits the uprights of the chip shot. And that will break our tie and give them a three-point lead.
So this one is over. A victory for Carolina. And it took a big fourth quarter to do it, but bottom line, they got the job done.
Yeah, it is the bottom line, isn't it? A few anxious moments along the way, though. A few sweaty palms, not just for the team, but for their fans. As you mentioned, down going into the fourth quarter. How about the rally? How about the comeback? Getting it done on both sides of the ball, holding them when they needed to, and finding ways to get points when they had the football.
So for the Panthers, the win moves them a couple games over 500 now at 7-5. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, it's a tough one to swallow as they drop back to 8-4 on the year. And they will be at home next week to take on the New York Giants.
I don't know.